Hello friends, myself Amar. Now in this video I will discuss about rule-based navigation. Okay. Now this rule-based navigation is used to perform both static as well as dynamic navigation. Dynamic navigation, as I discussed in my previous video, it will be based on some condition. Okay, if the user ID and password is correct, then it will move to some page A, and if the user ID and password is wrong, it will move to some page B, right? This type of navigation is called as the dynamic navigation, and this is generally performed with the help of rule-based navigation. Now this rules of navigation is written in faces config.xml file. Okay, if we write these rules in faces config.xml file, then what will happen, it will be very easier to manage the code. Means later on, if you want to change the page name, then it must be changed only in the faces config.xml file. If you are not writing these rules in faces config.xml, then if later on some changes are required, then we need to change each and every page, right? Now how to implement this rule based navigation using JSF, that I will show you programmatically. Okay, here I have created a managed bin. If you see here, I have created a managed bin user login, and it contains two properties. One is name property and another one is the password property. As you can see, two properties I have created, and here I have created a method also, that is a check login. Okay, inside this check login method, what I have written, if the name contains the value as Amar and if the password contains the value as Amar, then this function will return welcome, otherwise it will return failure. Okay, now here I have created this login page design, H colon panel grid, these things I have discussed already. Here I have created the design where input text is associated with the name property of the managed bin, and input secret is associated with the password property of the managed bin, right? And whenever I will click on the button, then the check login function of the managed bin will work. Okay, now if the user ID is, if the name is Amar and the password is Amar, then check login will return what? Welcome. And if I am providing some other values, then check login will return what? Failure, right? Now here what I have done, here in the configuration file, that is faces config.xml, here I have created the navigation rule. If you see in the navigation rule, here we have written from view ID index.html. This is the page from where the redirection will happen. From index.xhtml we will move either to welcome or to failure, right? Now to which page we will move, that is defined inside the navigation case. Inside the navigation case we have written from action user login.checklogin. Now this check login will return either welcome or failure. If the outcome is welcome, then to which view we will move, welcome.xhtml. And in another navigation case we have written, if the outcome is failure, then where we will move, we will move to failure.xhtml. This is how we can define the rules inside the faces config.xml. okay, now let me run this. And here I have already created this failure.xhtml and welcome.xhtml, right? Let me run this. Yes. This is the login screen. Now suppose here I am giving username as Amar, password as Amar, then it should return welcome.xhtml. okay, welcome user. Here you can see the URL is changed to welcome.xhtml. why this URL is changed, that I will discuss. But suppose I am providing something else, then see failure.xhtml is opening, where we have written please try again. Why this URL is changed? Because in the faces config.xml, here I have written a redirect. Okay, this means the redirect model is being applied. If you are not writing redirect, by default page a forward model will happen and the URL will not change. Okay, I hope you have understood this video. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.